The number one priority for first responders, especially fire, is being able to track and locate where their team members are at.
I think anybody that's spent any time doing first response has been in a situation where, you know, someone's gone missing or something's gone bad and you need to know where everyone's at immediately.
Pointer stands for Precision Outdoor, Indoor Navigation and Tracking for Emergency Responders. This is one of those we think is truly breakthrough technology that can address the indoor tracking problem.
So it's a technology that enables us to use devices that can be very small, that can be attached to first responders, that we can use to track them very accurately in complex structures such as a steel reinforced building. The moving currents in these wires are generating magnetic fields. So what Pointer does is generates these fields, and receivers sitting on the fire truck would sense these fields to enable a computer, for example, to show position and orientation of this device in the building.
Because the magnetic signals can actually penetrate through buildings and walls and caves and water, we're taking advantage of the fact that that magnetic signal can actually penetrate through those materials.
For us, in an urban environment, not only do we have large buildings, which it's real important to know where they are if we had a building fire, we had a collapse of that building, but it's also important to us to know for a wildland application where our personnel are in a broad area.
Someone calls on the radio and says that they need assistance or they've found someone who needs assistance. Now you've got a more accurate way of determining their exact location so you can bring additional assets to help them resolve whatever the issue is.
It's really novel just because it'll work in an infrastructure denied environment where GPS is not available, cellular technology is not available. That's really crucial for us. And in a wildland environment, this is the biggest challenge that we have.
The thing that's impressive is the 3D aspect of it. Anybody with a cell phone can tell you, oh, I know where I'm at, it tells me right here on my phone. Well, that's great when you're working on a 2D plane or a flat surface, but for first responders, we operate in different environments, operate underwater, operate in subterranean, operate in high rises.
We can see the first responder's rotation now on the user interface. We can also see when a first responder goes down. So if a first responder's standing upright and he or she goes down, we can actually see that motion of upright to down on the user interface. Right now in phase two, the transmitter is about the size of a shoebox. When we move to phase three, it's gonna go to about the size of something you could fit in the palm of your hand, and it's gonna be ounces. So start thinking about a button or something that may be on the PPE of a first responder, so they don't have to worry about doing anything other than putting on their PPE. This is the next big thing, if not the biggest thing, to be able to know where a firefighter's at any given time in any type of location and environment.